Callie Berg with the Greater Bridgeman Area Chamber and Growth Alliance. I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about the Makers Trail Festival coming up on June 9th from 1 to 10 at Waco Beach in Bridgeman, Michigan. The Makers Trail is a conglomeration of all the breweries, wineries, and spirit makers in Berrien County brought together by the Southwest Michigan Tourist Council, and we are fortunate to be able to produce their very first event. And today I have one of the makers, Lazy Ballerina, who has two tasting rooms, one in downtown St. Joe and one in Bridgeman, and we're here today at the Bridgeman Tasting Room with Melanie and Lauren, who are actually co-owners and cousins of Lazy Ballerina, and we are thrilled to be here today, ladies. Thank you for having us.
Thanks for coming.
I see you've poured us some wine to try today.
Yes, we did. So these are the four that we're going to be featuring at the Makers Trail Festival. Kind of a good mix of drier and sweeter. Summer hopefully is around the corner. I don't know if y'all are watching. It's April and it's snowing right now, so I think we're all really excited to be thinking about a festival on the beach. So we have some really good wines that'll go well with hopefully sunshine and warm weather. And we can try some if you want to try some.
Oh.
Of course. So first let's actually talk about the White Swan. We'll go in the right tasting order here, okay. Which is a drier white. It's one of our best-selling whites. And it's going to be very similar to a Pinot Grigio.
This one.
Okay.
Yep.
This is the White Swan right here. It's drier in style. It's got a little bit of fruit to it. I think it's a phenomenal summer wine.
Oh, that is delicious.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Glad you like it.
And we'll join you.
I know. Why not?
I was just going to say I'm passing the glass. I don't drink alone.
You don't drink alone. And hey.
Especially not
I do,
drinking.
But I always look for a good excuse not to. So.
And this is one of our favorites. So this one's light and crisp. It's a Pinot Grigio blend. Very refreshing, one of our most popular.
I can see why.
This is one of our favorites. Mm-hmm. So this is the White Swan.
Definitely.
Okay.
So next up, Sweeter Styles is actually not even released to the public yet. It is called Midas Niagara, named after our grandmother. And actually this is a photo of her on the wine label. So if you're not familiar with Niagara, it is a type of juice grape. It is a sweeter style. And we're actually gonna be releasing this officially on Mother's Day weekend, so it will be available in time for the festival.
Are you gonna have a party to celebrate the new wine?
Well, we're doing it on Mother's Day. We have a buy one, get one special for mothers and sons or daughters that wanna bring your mom in for the day. And I think that's it for Mother's
Day. Yeah, Mother's Day, we're the only woman-owned winery in Southwest Michigan. Mother's Day weekend tends to be pretty popular for us. So we have to work, so usually our family comes in, and hopefully yours do too.
I can smell the Concord grapes, which are my favorite.
So this is the Niagara, which is very similar. It's like the white Concord grape, basically.
Ooh, this is good.
We do have this available, but like we said, we haven't officially released it yet, so we're really excited about bringing it to the festival.
This is like Concord grapes in a wine glass.
Yeah. So
delicious.
Niagara is one of the wines that our grandma used to make homemade in the cellar, so that is why this is a tribute to her. This takes us back to our childhood drinking. Well, maybe not drinking it, but she did give us small sips of it when we were kids, just to try. So it's kind of a tribute to her.
We would get paid per lug of wine grapes that juice grapes at the time. And I've never filled a lug. If we were out there, we were eating the grapes. We were definitely not putting them to sell.
Yeah, I would be right there with you.
One of our next wines is our Cavalier. We are actually really excited. We're releasing this coming weekend. And this is a Chamberson blend done in stainless steel. So this is what we call our Great Summer Red. It's right here.
Okay.
It's dry, but it's done in stainless steel. So it's very refreshing. You can almost do it a little bit chilled in the summer, which is why we picked this one. We figure it's perfect for the beach.
Definitely please the dry wine drinkers, but it does have some fruit character that I think will not seem too dry to people who maybe don't normally love dry wines. So,
okay.
Pressure's on, you gotta say you like it.
That is so good. Where's the spaghetti?
Yes! Yeah. Pairs very well
delicious.
With Italian food.
Really robust, really strong flavor. It would pair well with a lot of food.
Yeah, really versatile. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Really good.
But also one that you can drink by itself.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
And then the final one, which this is kind of our flagship, or has been, we've really become known for this one, is our cranberry wine. It's 100% cranberry, so there's no grapes in it. Tastes just like cranberry juice with a kick. So it's all cranberry, no grapes. It's sweet, but it's a little tart on the end. This tends to be our best-selling wine overall, which we'll also be featuring at the festival. So that's, you can try it there.
Different. Yeah, so we're really excited about that one. That one won a gold medal. Mm-hmm. So it's very good.
Yeah.
Very nice, refreshing.
Nice and sweet.
Yeah. It's well balanced. It's not over the top and it's got that tartness. So really easy drinking.
I used to be a sweet wine drinker and then I became a dry wine drinker. And this is really, really good.
Yep.
For a sweet, it's not very sweet.
Yeah. I've even gotten creative. I've thrown a little vodka in there. So maybe at the Maker's Trail, you can try experimenting with some vodka and our cranberry wine. I'm all about it.
Well, I'm really glad that you guys are going to be coming to our festival. I think it's going to be a really wonderful day. And if folks can't make it to the festival, your tasting rooms are both open and you have website and Facebook page and people can learn more about you and come check you out.
Yeah, LazyValerinaWinery.com is our website. Check us out there. We're also on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter. We do have, like I said, two tasting rooms right here in Bridgeman, which is walking distance really from where the Maker's Trail Festival is going to be. And then our main winery is in St. Joseph. So you can visit either one of those tasting rooms. After Memorial Day, we're gonna be open every day at both locations, 12 to 6, 12 to 5 on Sundays. Come see us.
Yeah, and come to the festival where you can try all of Lazy Ballerina's choices that they're bringing that day, as well as many of our other makers who will be joining us for a fantastic day at the beach. Lots of wonderful local great live music and headliner Billy Strings. So please join us on Saturday, June 9th, 1 to 10, Waco Beach. You can get your tickets at makerstrailfestival.org and we'll hope to see you there.
We're excited about it.
Thank you, ladies. So am I.
Thanks for coming and drinking with us.
Thank you.